Hey, what's up with you guys? So today I want to talk to you about Sushiswap. We're going to see how it works and also how you can use liquidityfolio.com to track your position in Sushiswap and also understand in which pools to invest. It's going to be a kind of a medium to long session because I want to show you what Sushiswap is and the way it works, the different mechanism of yield, and then really show you how you can use the tool to track your ROI and track your position. So I'll start here where we are in Sushiswap.fi. It used to be Sushiswap.org, but there is a new website. This is kind of the official interface for Sushiswap. And as you can see here, the liquidity right now is about $2.9 billion with a $518 million of daily volume. And this is actually pretty impressive. So if we look at, for example, as Uniswap as a comparison, remember that Sushiswap really was born as a fork of Uniswap. Uniswap right now has about $4 billion, $3.9 billion of liquidity, and more than $1 billion, $1.2 billion in a swap on a 24-hour basis. But you know, basically, we in terms of liquidity, we're actually pretty close, and in terms of volume, maybe 50% of that. But I still believe it's very impressive of the scale that Sushiswap was able to obtain. And to be honest, like maybe some of you remember some of the early video that I published when Sushiswap came out, kind of September last year. I wasn't really sure this project would kind of succeed and the governance, you know, would succeed. But in fact, this project has evolved a lot, and so I decided to kind of explore it better and to integrate it on Liquidityfolio. And I think the team really introduced a few mechanism and a few incentive structure that proved to work pretty well, and we're really at the basis of this growth. And I want to kind of show you what I mean by that. So maybe before jumping in the interface and so on and so forth, I just put together a quick recap in terms of what's the yield mechanism, what the yield structure for Sushiswap. And basically, the yield on Sushiswap happened across four axes. The first axis are the fees. So if you're familiar with Uniswap or Balancer Curve, that's the same kind of idea. There is a in case of Sushiswap, 0.3% exchange fees, but the idea here is that differently to for example Uniswap, which doesn't have this mechanism yet, 0.25% of the fee is going directly to the LP, so similar to Uniswap, but 0.05%, which is 16% of the overall fee, is actually going as a distribution to Sushi holder, which basically are staking their Sushi into the Sushi bar, as we're going to see in a second. So this is important in my mind because the idea is that Sushi is now associated with a cash flow, right? And when you have a cash flow, when you have a token, in the case of Sushi, pretty much any security associated with a cash flow, is much easier to understand, a pricing of the security, similar to, in a sense, CRV. And so this is a very important fact to pay attention. The other mechanism, except the fees, are really all liquidity mining. And but there are a few kind of different components which caused to me a little confusion, so I want to make sure are clear with you. So the liquidity mining on Sushiswap happened across three kind of different modules. There are the so-called permanent farms, there are on-send farms, and then there's the Sushi bar. So now, the difference between the two farms, the permanent and the onsen, is really just the permanent or temporary nature of those liquidity mining opportunities. So with the permanent farms, there are about 20 pools that are kind of static, right? Those are the permanent liquidity mining opportunities that are going to be there in the future. And the mechanism there is stake your LP tokens and you earn the Sushi. On top of that, there is another kind of innovation by the Sushiswap team where the Sushi that you receive, about 1/3 of the entire Sushi amount, you're eligible, and then the other 2/3 will be kind of rewarded to you in 6 months. Now, to be honest, there's not yet in the smart contract this mention of the 2/3 in 6 months. I think the team will probably do some other distribution similar to what the Balancer team does every week. That's, I think, still a little bit TBD, but that's kind of the deal. The onsen farms is exactly the same thing. The only difference is that it's a kind of 40 to 50 pools, typically. Maybe this number will change in the future, but these are kind of temporary liquidity mining opportunities. So where the governance of Sushiswap believes there is a pool to incentivize, they will essentially create an incentive, a liquidity mining incentive, temporarily to kind of attract capital in that pool. But again, like the mechanism is the same. You stake LP tokens and you get Sushi. Then there is the sushi bar. Now, the sushi bar, basically, when you have sushi, either because you farm them or because you bought them, then you can essentially you can essentially lock the sushi into another smart contract, which is called sushi bar. When you lock the sushi, you get back X sushi, which is another token. But the idea is there is that basically this is the smart contract that allows you to collect this 0.05% of fees, which is actually 16%. I mean, if you do the proportion of the entire block of fees generated every day by just holding sushi. So this is kind of the, you know, liquidity mining, but it's actually more a cash flow component mechanism. So these are kind of, these are, you know, the core mechanism of yield with Sushiswap. There's the fee, the liquidity mining with the farms, and the sushi bar. Now, what I want to show you is how you can really track, you know, let's assume you add liquidity to Sushiswap. What can you do with Liquidityfolio to track your investment? So even before tracking the investment, to be honest with you, what you can do, you can go into the pool section. You're going to find Sushiswap right here. And even before investing, you can understand, you know, what's the yield of the different pools. You know, again, you can order them by liquidity or by the ROI. And you can see where the, you know, the incentive is coming from. So, you know, for example, on a 30-day basis, you know, if you invest in Ethereum YFI, you're going to get a 2.7%, of which 0.26 are fees and 2.49 are Sushiswap, or basically sushi mined. And on top of that, this is actually counting only the 1/3 of sushi that is coming to you immediately. And then the other 2/3, which is, you know, if you hover on top of this eye icon, you are going to see what's the additional income that you're supposed to get in 6 months when the distribution will happen, essentially. So this is kind of just to put things in context. If you haven't invested, you want to check out the yield of the sushi pools, you can go in the pool section and do that. And last thing is, if you already have invested, you have a portfolio of sushi, what can you do and how can you track your ROI? So basically, you, as usual, you come here, you add your own address where you invested with Sushiswap, and then you're going to get a detailed analysis of your LP position in Sushiswap. So for example, this, by the way, Sushiswap is this color right here, kind of, you know, a light purple. And for example, let's open this address, which has some liquidity invested in Sushiswap. As usual, you're going to be able to see your pools here. You're going to be able to see these two lines, the tick line and the continuous tick line is basically the value of your liquidity today, versus the dotted line is the value you would have if you add the same asset, but you didn't invest in Sushiswap. So you can understand here, you know, the impact of your fees and your impermanent loss. And by the way, you see always the delta here at the top of the chart. And here you see the mechanism of yield, really. So the blue are the fees and the yellow is the liquidity mining component that you're getting by providing liquidity. As usual, you can also zoom into each pool and you see more in detail the really evolution of the liquidity and the evolution of the rewards. And you can also see here how much of your pool tokens you staked in the you know, in the farms, and what's the size of the pool, what's the price of the assets, as well as you can see, you know, the different moments where you invested and divested the liquidity, you close your position in Sushiswap. You're going to be able to see the final kind of position here and the ROI and so on and so forth. As usual, so this is kind of what I wanted to tell you about Sushiswap, kind of a very high level. As usual, if you have any comment, feedback, thought, or need you know, any support with the tool, connect directly with me either on Telegram right here or on Twitter. Follow me and I'll respond to my DMs are open. And yeah, I hope you're going to enjoy this Sushiswap cover. I may actually record more videos, for example, in terms of Sushi Bar, which the you know, integration, specific integration with the Sushiswap bar is also coming soon, as well as I want maybe to do some calculators there because I think there may be some use. And so maybe updates coming on this. And until next time, have a great day, guys. Talk soon.